Hello friends, now we see the theorem which is a base on arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean of chapter, sequence and series. The theorem is if capital A comma capital G comma capital H are in arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean respectively of two positive numbers A and B, then we have to prove that arithmetic mean is greater than geometric mean, which further greater than harmonic mean. Number two, if A and B are equal, then we have to prove that arithmetic mean is equal to geometric mean is equal to harmonic mean. And number three, we have to prove that G square is equal to A into H. It means the geometric mean whole square is equal to product of arithmetic mean and harmonic mean. Now let's see the proof. The proof is quite simple. So let small a and small b be two positive unequal real numbers. Given capital A, capital G and capital H are arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean. Respectively of two numbers A and B, therefore we must have arithmetic mean capital A is equal to A plus B upon 2. The geometric mean capital G is equal to square root of A into B. And harmonic mean capital H is equal to 2AB upon A plus B. Now since small a and small b are positive unequal real numbers, so we must have A greater than B. Therefore A minus B greater than 0. On squaring both sides we get A minus B the whole square must be greater than 0. Now A minus B the whole square can be written as A square minus 2AB plus B square. Greater than 0. Therefore A square plus B square is greater than 2AB. Now to get the complete square on left hand side, we have to add 2AB on both sides. So we have a square plus 2ab plus b square Therefore, a plus b the whole square is greater than 2ab plus 2ab, we get 4ab. The next step will be a plus b the whole square upon 4 greater than ab. Now taking positive square root on both sides, we get a plus b upon 2 is greater than square root of ab, and therefore now a plus b upon 2 is our arithmetic mean. So we write by capital A, which is greater than, now square root of ab is our geometric mean, so that we treated as a capital G. So in this way we prove capital A is a greater than capital G, that is arithmetic mean is a greater than geometric mean. Let us this equation we have to denote as a 1. Now we have to prove that geometric mean is also greater than harmonic mean. So for that purpose, again we consider that let A and B be the two positive unequal real numbers, and therefore we have A must be greater than B. From that we write A minus B is greater than 0. On squaring both sides we get a minus b the whole square is greater than 0. The next step will be a square minus 2ab plus b square greater than 0. Therefore, a square plus b square is greater than 2ab. Now to get a complete square on left hand side, we have to add the term 2ab on both sides. So the next step will be a square plus 2ab plus b square is greater than 2ab plus 2ab. Therefore, now the left hand side is the complete square of a plus b the whole square, which is greater than, and on RHS we get 2ab plus 2ab is equal to 4ab. Therefore, the next step will be 1 is greater than 4ab upon a plus b whole bracket square. Now multiplying ab on both sides, we get 1 into ab, which is greater than 4ab upon a plus b the whole square into ab. So the next step will be ab is greater than 4a square b square upon a plus b the whole square. Now taking positive square root on both sides, so we must have a root AB is greater than, therefore the square root of AB is greater than 2AB upon A plus B. It means the geometric mean is greater than harmonic mean. Let us this denote as a equation 2. Then from equation 1 and 2 we conclude that arithmetic mean is greater than geometric mean and geometric mean is greater than harmonic mean. In this way, we prove the first part of theorem. Now we prove the second part. In second part, we have given that the two numbers are equal. Since A is equal to B, therefore, in that case, arithmetic mean A equal to A plus B upon 2. So that become A plus A upon 2. So therefore, A is equal to 2A upon 2. Cancelling 2 from numerator, denominator, we have capital A is equal to small a. Now same thing, that put A equal to B in the formula for geometric mean, we get geometric mean G equal to root AB. Therefore G equal to root A into A. Therefore G equal to a root A square, square and root cancel, so we have G equal to A. Similarly, put A equal to B in the formula for harmonic mean, so H is equal to 2AB upon A plus B. Therefore H is equal to 2A into A upon A plus A. Therefore H is equal to 2A square upon 2A. On cancellation we get H equal to A. So in this way we get arithmetic mean A equal to small a, geometric mean G also equal to small a, and harmonic mean H is also equal to small a. So from this we conclude that arithmetic mean must be equal to geometric mean and that equal to harmonic mean. In this way we prove the second part of the theorem. Now we consider the third part of the theorem. In third part, we have to prove that G square is equal to A into H. So we consider first LHS. Therefore, left hand side is equal to G square. Now geometric mean capital G, we replace the formula root AB the whole square. Square and root cancel. So we have left hand side is equal to AB. Now we consider a right hand side. The right hand side is A into H, that is arithmetic mean into harmonic mean. So that equal to, now for arithmetic mean capital A, we have to write A plus B upon 2. And for harmonic mean capital H, we have to write 2AB upon A plus B. Then we cancel A plus B from numerator denominator and 2 from numerator and denominator. So we left with right hand side is equal to AB. So in this way we prove left hand side is equal to right hand side, and hence we prove the formula that G square is equal to A into H. So in this way we prove all three parts which are occurred in the theorem. So this is required proof for the given theorem. Thank you.